This video is sponsored by ExpressVPN. Unless you've spent hours reading all the fine print of incognito mode, you might not know that when you use it, many people can still view your browsing activity, like your employer, your school, even your internet service provider. Your home internet provider can see and record your browsing data, and in the United States, it's even legal for them to sell that information to advertisers. To protect your online privacy, ExpressVPN, an app that encrypts all of your network data and reroutes it through a network of secure servers so your online activity can actually stay private. It works on all devices and could not be simpler to activate. Just tap one button to connect and your activity is safe from snooping eyes. Lots of cheap or free VPN services make a profit off of selling your data to advertisers, but not ExpressVPN. They've actually even developed their own trusted server technology, making their VPN servers incapable of storing your data at all. One of my favorite ways to use ExpressVPN is to unlock geo-restricted content. There's lots of streaming services that you can only have access to if you live within a certain country. So I like to pull up BBC iPlayer, change my location to the UK in order to watch UK cooking shows like Nadia's Time to Eat. Take back your internet privacy today. Be sure to use my link below, expressvpn.com/moon, to get an extra 3 free months of ExpressVPN. Hi there, how are you doing today? Great. Do you have an appointment? Perfect. I'll just go ahead and look you up in the books. Last name, please. There you are. You're just in time for your 5 o'clock appointment. So it looks like I don't have anything down for you for the look you're going for today. Do you have anything in particular in mind, or were you wanting to peruse through the catalog? Take a look at the catalog, sure. Where are you headed tonight? You're hoping to give at the party? Would you prefer to look cute, sexy, cool, scary, mysterious? Something cute, but also a little spooky. Okay, that's fine. Let me see what I have for you. First, I'd like to recommend our candy corn look. This has been pretty popular this year. It's nice if you're not wanting to go like super all out. You don't really even have to have a costume to go with it. You can just wear all black or candy corn colors, you know, the orange, the yellow, the white. And this is a festive way to top it off. So we'll do nice, fresh, dewy skin with a white, yellow, and orange treatment. Blushy cheeks and nose, glossy orange lips, very polished finish, nice touches of highlight to the nose and the cheekbones and the inner corners, and my favorite part, the star of the show, these smatterings of little painted on candy corns, aren't those sweet? Here we have a pretty scary demon, succubus, seer, you know, whatever you want. But it is pretty creepy, with the whited out eyes, the third eye on the forehead, red skin all over, heavy contour to really sculpt out the edges, and shadows. Harsh, well-defined brow, a glossy red lip, high And then these intricate, fine line blackwork designs, sharp eyeliner and eyebrows, all around the eyes, reaching down onto the cheekbones. I think this look really complements the features well. Strikes that perfect balance of sexy and scary. I think you could wear, if you've got any evening gowns, like a slick, you know, silky black dress, maybe a bit of drapery at the top, something long with a slit up the leg, with some red or black heels, maybe glittery, and any nice jewelry you have. Imagine this look with some ruby earrings and a diamond necklace. Our most popular look this year by far has been Barbie. It's a very simple look, but it's easy to get it wrong. It's very important to have the exact right shade of pink for these lips, and I have nailed the formula. So, nice crisply outlined lips, filled in with pink lipstick, and finished off with the perfect polish of clear gloss. Flawless skin. We'd really go in with the Too Faced Primed and Poreless Primer for this look to make sure that your skin really does look like plastic. Not a single pore, line, bit of texture, anything to be seen. It's like glass. A nice, well manicured brow. Not too sharply angled, not too straight across, just that nice, soft sculpt. A nude lid with a pink cut crease defined with brown liner. The cut crease is very important to Barbie's eye look. A light, light line, quite thin, of black liner to define those eyes, and just a kiss of brown shadow along the lower lash line. Delicate nose contour, cheek. It off with a dewy mist of finishing setting spray to make sure it lasts perfectly all night. You can't have Barbie makeup starting to melt off as you're dancing, anything like that. And also, a dewy setting spray will enhance that plasticky finish we'd be going for. So for this, you could go with a pink dress, a white dress, some light blue jeans with a cute top. Anything really. Barbie's got so many different looks, but it would just have to be something pretty polished and cute. Alien look. This one's pretty unique. As with any of these looks, we can customize the color scheme to anything that you would personally like. We could do a pink. this example we have in green, I do find that the alien looks do come across best with a pastel-y shade. Looks quite cute. So we've got this pastel green with some heavy darker green contours to sculpt out some alien cheekbones, chin, nose. It's kind of a snake nose with those black eyeliner slits for the nostrils. Lots of sculpting with highlights and contours around the eyes to really reshape those. We are drawing new eyes on for you with heavy, heavy handed black liner and little touches of white highlighter to kind of sell the illusion. A blushy cheek and some white designs to kind of add that somewhat futuristic touch. And I did choose purple as the secondary color for this look, so we've got purple brows, purple hair, and a dark purple lip with gloss. We can always do a matte lip if you like, or a glitter lip even, but I do love the gloss. So this would look cool with any sort of futuristic getup you might have. I also think that it could look cute to just wear like sweatpants. Just a casual alien. Maybe. Okay. If you'd like to lean a bit more into the scary side of things, I'd suggest this take on Jigsaw's makeup. So we've got a face that's painted completely white, heavily powdered, so you won't have to worry about it budging as you sweat. Very, very smoked out eyes with red liner in the waterline to give that creepy, crazed look. And watery black drips coming down from the eyes as if the eyeshadow and liners are melting. Glittery red spirals on the cheeks. They look so beautiful, especially in party style lighting. I find that glitter looks its very best in quite a dim, dark space, but with minimal light sources, that's where it really is able to shimmer and shine. And then, of course, we've got black liner to convey the marionette chin. 1920s-inspired cutesy clown look. This one has the super fun detail of a white heart in the center of the face, bordered in a ring of pearls. We've got a white and black glitter cut crease, the brows covered and replaced with very weepy, sad 1920s movie star style brows, super duper blushed on the apples of the cheeks and the nose, giving a sort of soft, This next one is Muffet from Undertale. So we'd paint your skin completely pastel purple. Cover your brows. Do pink and purple smoky eye. And paint on 1, 2, 3 extra eyes on your forehead. Some nice or if you'd maybe like to go for something a little more subtle, we have this adorable fairy look that, again, we could do in whatever colors you'd like. If you'd like to be a pink fairy, a blue fairy, green fairy. But this one has a pink, and white color scheme. So we've got flawless, fresh, dewy skin. Highlighter, a glossy pink lip, a smattering of white freckles, and then the best part of the look is obviously these intricate white lined designs with a bit of blending around the edges, just shading that in, a bit of a gradient to really help them stand out. And these designs look somewhat floral, somewhat butterfly-esque. In any case, they definitely look fairy-like. You think you'd like to go with Miss Muffet? Awesome. I'm so glad. This look is a lot of fun to do. So, are there any adjustments or customizations you'd like me to make for you? Or would you like me to just adhere strictly to the face chart as it's depicted here? Okay, so a bit heavier on the eyeshadow. Do you like the pink and purple? Yeah, but maybe like some black around the outer corners to just smoke it out more dramatically. And maybe bold further into the crease, sure. And some glitter, yeah, I agree, in the inner corners or at the centers of the lids. The inner corners, yeah, I think that will definitely kind of sell the illusion. Now that your hair is out of the way, we can get started with your lovely face. I'm going to be using Revolution's Glass Liquid Skin Illuminating Skin Primer. This stuff is excellent for establishing a perfect, flawless base to work off of. And the illuminating aspect more realistic that way than, you know, packing a powder illuminator on top. That's nice for adding a bit of extra punch to the most protruding areas, like the tip of the nose, the very tippy tops of the cheekbones, things like that. But as far as accomplishing that overall glow to the skin, your face is all primed, it's time to cover up those brows. Now you're gonna have to trust me on this one. Don't be scared. It's perfectly safe, I promise you. This is, in fact, the industry standard Elmer's washable school glue stick. This stuff washes out just fine with soap and water, or your regular face wash and water. I need to mix up the perfect pastel purple shade for you. It's going to be mostly comprised of white, since it is such a light color. But then we will, of course, need a touch of cobalt. Just ever so slight, small amount. And a smidge of crimson as well. amazingly well.
But in order for this purple base to come across as the proper texture with no brush strokes, or streaks, or any even blotches, we do need to go in with a beauty blender sponge. This is going to give us that perfect polished purple finish we're after. Just going to go over all of those areas once again. Starting with your forehead. Going down the nose. Under your eyes. The cheeks.
Now we've got to powder you up so that this purple paint does not budge. I'm using the original RCMA no color powder. This stuff is super versatile. If we were to use a purple powder, we'd kind of be doubling up on the color and adding opacity. The next step I'm very excited about. Blush is one of my favorite parts of every look, but particularly with this one, because I love how pink and purple look together, and I love how Muffet is just so cute, and I think that the ultra blushy cheeks are where her personality really starts to come through in the look. I'm loading up my brush with this gorgeous and this is sort of going to act both as blush and as contour, just with the way that we're placing it, using it to carve out the cheekbone somewhat, packing on the pigmentation most heavily there in the shadow of the apple of the cheek, and then pulling it up, blending it higher than that. And then, as a kind of blush topper highlight, in the shade Kitten Parade. This is a stunning pink with golden shimmers that is going to look right at home on the tippy tops of your cheekbones, the tip of your nose, center of your forehead, and the tip of your chin. Now comes the extra eyes. Going to use NYX, That's the Point. This is a wonderfully chubby eyeliner. Look, it's like a marker tip. I love felt tip liners. So, it's the perfect size for the job. And this felted tip is really going to lend itself well to sculpting out those sharp, crisp outer edges of these eye illusions. So to start right there, draw up, drawing the inner corner, upper lid, lower lid, outer corner, and then fill it in. Going to hit your lids with a touch of Urban Decay's Primer Potion, the original formula, to blot that over the lids. Then use my ring finger to eyeshadows. I'm going with the Revolution Maxi Reloaded palette. Going in with light purple, dark purple, light pink, dark pink, these medium pinks as well. Blending those all together with a touch of black from a different palette, like you requested, those outer corners. I'm going to start onto this darker plum. for those white highlights on the eyes, I want to use the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade Milk. Milk. Milk, milk, milk. But this does need to be freshly sharpened because we're doing a really tiny highlight. So we need that dip to come to a quite fine point. That should do it. Is it alright if I place one of my hands on your jaw like this to help steady myself for this part? Let's do those glitters you requested. I'm using the R-O-M-A-N-D Romand. This is the Better Than Palette 00 Light and Glitter Garden for your glitter. This palette. I use this one quite a lot on myself, just on a daily basis. So let's pick up a generous, healthy helping of Dewdrop. Really packing it onto that little brush. And dab that into each inner corner. Really brings out your eyes. They look so shiny now. I think it could look really cute to add some extra touches of sparkles to your cheeks. We could use this Twinkle Toes Glitter Gel by Slay Fire Cosmetics. It's called Twinkle Toes because it's time for the lashes, and we do have a few options here depending on what you personally prefer. Everybody is looking for something a little different with their lashes. The first option is from KISS, Kiss Lash Couture Naked Drama. These are best for fullness, fluffiness, volume. And they've got the cushion flexi band for a seamless and contoured fit. These are extremely comfortable. The bands aren't stiff and rigid and pokey like many often are. They're very soft and lightweight, and they'll easily flex to the shape of the contour of your lid, so you really won't feel them at all throughout the night. And this is in the design Ruffle. I like that these do have an expensive look to them. They do almost look like mink lashes because they are so fluffy with such delicate tips. The tips taper off to such incredibly like needle fine points. I find that that adds a kind of luxurious impression to a lash. The next option are Ardell Wispies. These are really popular with a lot of celebrities because they don't show up in photos. The bands visually really blend invisibly into your lid, and the lashes give that like better than natural look. They don't look like you're wearing anything too dramatic or heavy. You just look naturally, you know, like you have gorgeous eyes that are very beautifully defined by healthy, lush lashes. So if you'd like to compare, you can see that these offer more volume and these offer more of a natural effect. Or you could go with the Loxia Spiky Lashes, what I'm currently wearing. I love a spiky lash, and I think that they go perfectly with costume looks because those defined spikes look very nice standing out against dramatic makeup. Yeah, and they do have a bit of like a cartoonish look. A lot of people call these manga lashes. I think they look beautiful on everyone. These do have a bit of a thicker band, but it's not uncomfortable, and I almost kind of like it because it doubles as eyeliner. You wanna go with these? Okay, great. Then would you prefer for the lash glue to be dark or clear? Dark or clear? Dark or clear? You got it. Okay, I'm going to pick up a lash with my little lash tool. Here's my little lash tool that is perfectly suited for the job of applying lashes. It's so much easier than trying to use your fingertips or tweezers. Just going to apply the lash. Apply on the glue. Stick of the 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 you like to do lashes on the forehead eyes as well. I think that could really help them look more three-dimensional. Okay, let's pick up another lash. To make sure that your lips are properly prepared, I'm going to apply a touch of red currant balm and very carefully and gently paint that on for you. This is going to moisturize, nourish, and ever so slightly. Lips. I've got this adorable Sugar Bell lipstick. It's a nice soft pink. This is a nice clear gloss. It smells like cherries. Very long lasting. High quality. Or we can go with a pink gloss. This is Watercolor Rose. It's a bit less thick than Wet Cherry. It's thinner and more watery, so it might wear off faster. Alright, my dear, that completes your Muffet transformation. Go ahead and take a peek in the mirror just there. Let me know what you think. If you'd like any touch-ups, any adjustments, anything like that. You're happy with it? Good, I'm so glad. You really do look amazing. I hope you'll have the most fabulous time at your party tonight. And I'm sending you away with a goodie bag. Who gets their Halloween makeup done with me this year is going to receive a complimentary treat bag to wish you a very, very happy, happy, happy Halloween. will get inside here is a Happy Halloween card with a complimentary Sephora gift card inside, so you can pick out a special Halloween treat for yourself. A set of 24 glow-in-the-dark ghost stickers. A lovely night, my dear.